Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at creating texture in objects in Illustrator, and there are lots of ways to do this. The way that we're going to use today is we're going to poke holes in an object to see a background behind it. I'm using an element from a Design Cuts collection. It's from the Freebies, Vector Florals, Avatars, Patterns, Shapes and Banners, and it's the heart here that I'm using. I have this already open here in Illustrator. I'll have a look in the layers palette before I begin, which is something I'll do before I use any piece of stock, just to see how it's all put together so I can understand it a little bit better. Here we have a group. It's called Heart 29, but it is a group. You can tell it's a group when you select it. You'll see that Object Ungroup is an option. If that confuses you, you can always ungroup it and then regroup it, and this time you'll have the word group instead of the name Heart 29. But basically everything here has been added to a group. You've got your heart and all your dashes. Well, we're going to start recoloring it. So I'm going to select the heart itself, and I'll color that a sort of pink color. And then I'll select all the little dashes around it. I can do that by selecting the entire group and then hold the shift key as I click here on this little box. And that removes the heart from the selection, leaving just the little dashes around the heart selected. I'm going to color them a different color. I'm doing that because I want you to see that the texture that will apply to these combined shapes is going to work on even multicolored shapes. So you could select quite complex objects and texture them this way. We'll create our own texture from a brush. I'll open the brushes panel here, click the flyout menu, choose Open Brush Library, and then Artistic, and then Artistic Chalk Charcoal Pencil. This is one of the brush sets that's included with Illustrator. Just drag the topmost brush out of the brushes panel. This is just a nice brush to use for some quick texturing. You could, of course, scan and convert your own texture into a vector. There are all sorts of things that you could do. This is just a simple way, and I know everybody's got exactly the same thing they can use. Let's go to the group selection tool. Just going to drag slightly in the bottom area here where there's no content that I can see, because I know that there's going to be a box around this brush, because there's a box around every brush. Switch to the selection tool, press delete to remove the box. Next up, I'll go in with the group selection tool and target and delete anything that's really big in terms of texture shapes here. Because these black areas are going to be poking a hole in my heart, I don't want the pieces that are going to be poking holes to be overly big. Select everything, Alt or Option, drag a duplicate away just to build up a slightly larger piece of texture. Select over both of these textures. Here you'll see that everything's in two groups. With them selected, let's choose Object Ungroup, and continue to do that until ungroup is no longer an option. So we're undoing a whole lot of grouping that was applied to the original brush. Stop when you get to just individual paths, but don't let go of this selection, because you'll choose object group again. That just puts everything that was in multiple groups back in a single group. Nice, clean, tidy layers palette. This texture is going to need to be much larger, so I'll hold the shift key as I just drag it out to make it larger. It's going to need to cover the heart. You can also stretch it in any direction, because you don't really need to keep it in proportion, because who can tell what the texture looked like when it's in proportion? The texture's not the sort of thing that you can say, well, that's not in proportion, because it's just little dashes. I'm positioning it roughly where I want it to be, and I'll choose Edit and then Cut, because I want to cut it to the Windows or the Mac clipboard. I'll select back over the heart, and the easiest way to apply a texture, while you can do it through the Appearance panel, is actually to use the Transparency panel. Choose Window and then Transparency. I like the Transparency panel because it doesn't close up on you the same way that the Appearance panel does. With our shape selected, we'll click Make Mask. We'll also target the mask here and turn off the clip. That's really important, because we don't want our mask to actually act as a pair of scissors on our shape. We just want to poke some holes through it. It's a slightly different concept. With the mask itself selected, we'll choose Edit and then Paste in Place, because we cut the texture out. We're going to paste it back in right over where we had it, and it comes in sized and positioned exactly as it was. The mask here is eating away at the heart and at the dashes. That's exactly what we want it to do. If you're ever unsure, if you ever get a result that you don't like, make sure that you select your mask, and you can experiment with things like clip. And obviously clip in this circumstance, it's not the right option. Inverse mask, well, that's not actually poking holes in our heart, so it's not what we want. Once you've finished working with your mask, you need to go back to working with your object, because you'll see here that the layers palette says layers opacity mask, and everything's missing. We can't see our heart. We can't see all little pieces around the heart. And if we just click away and start trying to work, nothing's going to work the way we expect it to. So we need to move from working on the mask back to working with the art itself. Here our layers palette comes back looking the way we expect it to. At this point, we can close the transparency dialog because we're done with it. You'll see in the layers panel that everything looks exactly as it did before we applied the texture to the objects. So we're not actually seeing the texture itself in the layers palette. The only warning we've got that there is a texture applied to this shape is that the word group now has an underline under it. Even if you were to rename this group Heart 29 like it was in the first place, it would still have an underline under it telling you that there's something here that is affecting this combined group of shapes. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator texturing and masking techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.